Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Liz Patterson is the name. And I have the honour to be the Australian cultural attaché to the Court of St James. And if I may say so, on this beautiful old muggy autumn night in London City, you're all looking pretty good. And if you think I'm looking good, let's hear you say you're looking good, Liz. How am I looking, ladies and gentlemen?
You're looking good, Liz.
No worries. We're going to get along like a house on fire tonight, ladies and gentlemen. This is a very proud moment for Australia tonight. I must apologise to you that I was a little bit on the late side, Carl, missing your overture. I was held up on my way to this delightful venue. I was held up, my driver, I have a Commonwealth car in perpetuity from the government of Australia, but I was held up on my way here. Unfortunately, my driver was breathalysed. His name is Jerry, and he's aptly named. He's always full. Are you with me? Are you with me? I said, Jerry, you're full. Your place is under the bed. It takes a while to get it, ladies and gentlemen. It does. If you're married to my wife, you'd be lucky if you got it once a year. I'm telling you that. I've had a few drinks tonight, ladies and gentlemen. As a matter of fact, I'm as full as a pommy complaint box tonight. You with me? I'm as full as a seaside shithouse on bank holiday, but that... No! I'm sorry. No. Please forgive me. No, that just slipped out. I'm sorry. You know the feeling, fellas? No worries. No worries. No, that was parliamentary language, ladies and gentlemen. I do apologise. That was a low thing to say. I'm that low I could parachute out of a snake's arsehole, ladies and gentlemen. I could. And still free fall, I could. Oh, I've put my boot in it now, haven't I? They'll have to wipe that off the tape. Because all this is being filmed for posterity and being put in a time capsule, and why not? Life's too short. This is a proud moment for Australia, and there could be those of you who are unacquainted with our beautiful continent down there on the other side of the world, and you've just got a big privilege waiting for you, that's all I can say. And we're very, very fond of England too, contrary to what a lot of people might think. We are. Little pommies, as we call them. We don't know the origin of that word. Pom. It said that it was the initials of prisoner of Her Majesty that the old convicts used to wear, embroidered on the back of their pajamas. I don't know. It could be. It could be. This is a possible explanation etymologically. It doesn't matter. All I can say is we're very fond of the old country, and I'm not going to get too sentimental because I'm a very emotional person. I can only say that it hurts a bit still coming through Heathrow and standing around like a spare prick at a knock shop wedding. It hurts hanging around immigration with your Australian passport in your hand, seeing all them yashmaks and leather masks wafting through. All them camels and tea towel heads, through they go. Poor old Aussies hanging around. And you may wonder why I'm all dressed up like a pox doctor's clerk tonight. The reason is that I'm a top Australian... I'm sorry. I hope that Stradivarius is waterproof. That's all I can say. No, ladies and gentlemen, I have to dress like this all the time, being a top Australian diplomat, and it's marvellous. Wherever I go in the world, whether it's London, Paris, New York, Athens, Greece, any of them dago joints, it's a nice feeling to know they judge Australia by me, ladies and gentlemen, they do. And that gives me a lovely warm feeling deep down, I can tell you that. Deep down where it really counts. How does a Mexican know he's hungry, ladies and gentlemen? Hey? When his ass stops itching. Have you heard that one? Ah, oh, it's a beauty. Christ, I'm pissed tonight, ladies and gentlemen. No! There's an old Sheila down here, she can hardly believe her eyes, ladies and gentlemen. She's got a face like a half-sucked mango, this old tart. She hasn't cracked one yet. Wish I could say the same for myself. Anyway, please. I'm all dressed up like this because this is a big moment for Australia. A big musical moment. And fortunately, I'm associated with it. What I'd like to introduce you tonight is a musical work called Peter and the Shark. Now, this is a saga of Australian life. It's a bit like the little Mowgli of the Jungle Books, an Australian equivalent. You with me? Peter and the Shark, it's a typical story of an Australian surf rider and what he gets up to with his little marsupial mates behind the sand dunes. I'm not going to give away any more of the story, except I'm very, very ably helped here by Carl Davies and the Lazo. Now, the boys of the Lazo, that's the name of their group. It's spelled LSO, and it's the Lazo, and they're a ripper group, ladies and gentlemen, and you're going to enjoy every note of it. Now, different instruments impersonate some of the characters in this. First of all, there's a central character of Peter. You with me? Peter is represented on the piccolo trumpet, played by Maurice Murphy. Oh, tantalizing, Maury. Oh, yeah. That's it. Thank you, Maury. Very beautiful. That was Peter's theme. And the theme of the kookaburra. Kookaburra is a jolly little bird we have in Australia. Starts pretty early in the morning. It's the thing that wakes most Australians up. I won't tell you what wakes me up every morning. All I can say is you can hardly notice it under me duvet. No. Come on, it's a family show. The kookaburra is represented on the soprano saxophone by Jack Brimer. Good on you, Jack. Old Jack, he's a good old muso from way back too, Jack. We've had a few beers together, haven't we, Jack, from time to time? No worries. I'm sorry, son. Oh, here we come. A couple of latecomers creeping in here. Oh, she's beautiful too, son, eh? Oh. I think we can guess what kept you, eh, fella? Hey, all right. Oh, good. Anyway. Yes, just move along. Tread on their chocolates, that's the stuff. Now, where were we, for Christ's sake? Oh, yes, the platypus. This is a funny marsupial. Australia was cut off from the rest of the world for millions of years. You mightn't have known that. And there are a few forms of animal life that are developed down under that you can't find anywhere else. The platypus is one of them. It's a funny little hybrid with a beak and little webbed feet, you know. Delightful little creature. And this is represented on the bassoon by Martin Gatt. No, Martin. You'll have to take it from the top, son. Okay. No worries, Mark. Beautiful. Fair enough? Lovely. You've got to empty a lot of drivel out of that, have you, Mark? No instrument? I love it, don't you, when you see the fellas tipping the drivel out of their instruments? I've got a vision of one night, a whole orchestra of bassoons, you know? You know, open the doors of the Albert Hall in the end and, you know, everyone gets washed down the street, you know? Can you see it? It's my mind. I've got a funny Renaissance type of mind. Because Australia is where it's at. Films, mention films, macrame. Novels, Australia springs to your mind, whether you bloody well like it or not. And by cripes, it's going to tonight, ladies and gentlemen, when you cop this. This is the dingo. Now, the dingo, it's an animal, contrary to what some of you might think. It's a dog, it can be savage, but it's only fatal if it bites you. Fair enough? The next instrument is the bass clarinet played by Roy Jowett. Roy, let's have the dingo theme. That's beautiful. Thank you. It's a big one. You have to do it sitting down, I suppose, do you, son? Fair enough. Oh, you're trying to make something of that now, are you? The next character in our little symphonic saga is a person. It's Beachcomber Bill, a senior citizen in our little yarn. Beachcomber Bill is played on the trombone by Chris Mowat. Pretty good too, eh? Fair enough. Now, the villain of the piece is the shark. The shark is a popular Australian fish, ladies and gentlemen. You with me? Now, the shark is played by the timpani, the brass, and the tutty. What's a tutty? And everyone. Now, the chopper squad. The chopper squad. Or a bunch of helicopter blokes. And they are represented by the strings with the woodwinds creeping in, am I right? Beautiful. Now, you're in for a musical feast. Yes. You're in for a musical feast now, ladies and gentlemen, as I proceed with a fascinating saga of Peter and the Shark.